When it comes to creating engaging virtual webinars, what matters most is not only your content, but the kind of platform you use and how you use it. And that's what I'm going to cover in this video. You'll see the ins and outs of Livestorm's video engagement platform and gain actionable tips for activating your audience. Hi guys, I'm Daniela, Content Manager at Livestorm, the all-in-one video engagement platform for hosting all of your online meetings and events. Now, I've already covered the benefits of a video engagement platform and why it's a future of video communication. In case you forgot, I'll drop some resources in the description below. For now, let's get to the nitty-gritty and focus on engagement. I'll cover Livestorm's core engagement features, how you can customize your webinar, and tips for activating your audience at each stage. Are you ready to get started? Let's go. Before entering the Livestorm event room, you have the option of adding your own virtual background. In addition to these pre-made ones and the blur filters, you can upload your own by clicking on this icon here. If you're looking for some cool ones, I recommend heading over to our website and checking out our virtual background library, which I'll link in the description below. We have over 100 to choose from, and they're completely free. Once you've chosen your background, you'll need to save it and then click Join Event and Participate. As a quick note, this option is for when you'll be presenting on stage, but if you're just moderating the webinar and you won't be speaking, you'll click Join as Viewer instead. Welcome to the Livestorm event room. If you're already a customer or you've attended a Livestorm event in the past, it might be very familiar to you. But if you're new, don't hesitate to sign up for free to follow along. I'll leave it linked in the description below. On the Livestorm platform, we have several tabs in the sidebar, which are dedicated to chat, asking questions, and running live polls. Let's go over all of them first, and I'll provide tips for using them right after. In the chat tab, before your event starts, you'll see a little message which gives you the option to activate emoji reactions. By doing so, your attendees will be able to react with these emojis during your event. In the chat, everyone has the ability to write messages, to mention someone, to send emojis, and to send links to a Dropbox or Google Drive. If you're a team member or a guest speaker, you have additional permissions. You can invite someone to present. You can also block an attendee, and you can remove any unwanted messages. You also have the option to chat privately together in the chat's moderators tab so that the rest of the audience won't be able to see it. Moving on to the poll tab, this is where you can ask a question to your participants. And to add a new poll, you can do so by clicking on the Add Poll button and then click New Poll. You can then type in your poll question along with the multiple choice answers, which are listed under Options. Now, you have the choice to launch your own poll directly or to save it as a draft and publish later. At Livestorm, we recommend preparing all of your polls in advance by saving them as drafts. And keep in mind that you can do this in the event room at any time, even before your event starts. And when it's time to launch the poll, you or your team members can click on the three dots and then on the Publish Poll button. As for the questions tab, this is where participants can ask their questions when they click on the button below. Their question will appear next to their name, and other attendees will have the ability to upvote their questions. And there are two ways to answer, either by responding in writing in the blank box, or the person presenting can choose to answer live by clicking on the Start Live Answer button. A pop-up window will then appear like this, and when you're done, simply click I'm done answering to remove it. And this feature is particularly great because it puts a spotlight on a question, directing everyone's attention to it while it's being answered. Now, don't think that you're limited to only these engagement features in the event room, because you also have the ability to add plugins. And plugins are additional components that can be downloaded to unlock extra features, and they're great for customizing your events. At Livestorm, plugins are created by us, our partners, and they can even be created by you if you're not afraid of a little coding. I'll leave a link in the description if you'd like to learn more. And when it comes to customization through plugins, the sky is really the limit. You can create just about anything. For example, a shopping cart, a custom chatbot, virtual backgrounds, custom commands, and so much more. When you download a plugin, it will appear in the event room under Apps. To browse new ones, you can click Install More, which is a shortcut to your app's marketplace in your Livestorm workspace. Now, I won't go into too much detail on all the different plugins as they're being added regularly and the marketplace is constantly evolving. For the purpose of this video, I'll stick to a couple relevant ones like the Custom Design plugin, which allows you to customize the event room so you can add your own branding, like your logo, background image for both desktop and mobile, your background color, and your primary color, which is the color of your buttons, links, and tags. And I'll also show you the Handouts app, which allows you to share downloadable files with participants. All you need to do is click on the Handouts, and then you have the option to drag, drop, or browse files. Remember to respect the size limit and don't forget to click Publish so that it appears for your participants. Now let's take a look at how you can put these engagement features and plugins to use at each stage of your event. To start, we always recommend enabling emojis because they give attendees a really easy way to communicate without the noise and unnecessary chatter. Plus, if you're on the other end and you're presenting, it's really nice to see how others react, and it's a great way to add a little live interaction from participants. So before starting your webinar, we recommend adding a welcome message in the chat tab so it appears when your attendees enter the event room. To warm everyone up, you can ask your attendees to say hello and where they're tuning in from. They'll see it once you officially start your event. And once you begin your event, you'll want to let your audience know how they can interact in the event room, especially for those new to Livestorm. So you can tell them what the different tabs are for example, that they can answer your questions in the poll tab and ask their own in the question tab. And as a quick tip, there are occasionally audience members who forget and ask their questions in the chat. Don't hesitate to send them a friendly reminder because it really helps to keep things organized and avoid their questions getting lost in the chatter. And if you'd like to get some early interaction in from the start, why not ask your audience a question? Adding a poll in the beginning of your presentation is a great way to set the scene and get to know your attendees. For example, if your webinar is on social media marketing, you can start by asking the attendees what their preferred social network is. Now let's talk about what you can do to engage your audience during your event. So starting with your content, you'll want to make sure that it's high quality and captivating because think about it. In a virtual setting, your content is your event. With Livestorm, you can upload different files and share media in the event room, and we recommend doing so before the start of your event so that everything is prepared and ready to go. You can do so by clicking on the Share in the sidebar, and let's go ahead and upload a PDF presentation by clicking on this button here. Once this pop-up opens, you can drag and drop a file or upload one from your computer. Keep in mind that your files need to conform to the size limit, and if it's already uploaded, simply click Choose This Media. Now, what's especially great about this feature is that each presenter can control their own presentation, so you can avoid those annoying questions like, "Can you please move to the next slide?" When you're ready to remove your media, simply click on the X in the top right corner of the stream and click Confirm. Now, I suggest mixing up your presentation with powerful visuals and video whenever possible to avoid cognitive overload. It'll give your attendees a much needed break, and you can even add additional polls to continuously include them in the conversation. And during your presentation, we recommend having a team member help moderate your event so that your audience can have their questions answered even while you present. As I mentioned in the beginning, there's the option to answer questions in writing, and this is how your moderators can provide support. The ability to order your questions is especially useful because one of the options is to order by unanswered, and this will make sure that no question goes unnoticed. As your event comes to an end, there's still opportunities to keep the engagement going. Are you including guest speakers in your event? Why not wrap up your presentation with a rapid-fire question session? Keep it lighthearted, fun, and make sure to include your audience by asking the same questions in the poll. For example, if your event is about trends in remote work, some rapid-fire questions can include work from your desk or your sofa, lunch at home or out, sweatpants or no sweatpants. As you can see, these are less formal questions and a fun way to just get some laughs in while learning a little more about your guests and the audience. At the end of your event, you have the possibility to also send a call to action by clicking on the share icon in the sidebar and then clicking on send call to action. A pop-up will appear where you can add your parameters, including the CTA text, the button text, and the URL where you'll be redirecting your audience to. And this is especially useful if you'd like to redirect your audience to a particular page. For example, if you work in sales, you might want to redirect attendees to your company pricing page. And if you're looking to share downloadable files with your audience rather than redirecting them to a website, you can use the Handouts plugin that I mentioned earlier. All your attendees need to do is click on Apps and then Handouts. And if you've already uploaded and published your files, all of them will appear here. When using a CTA or a Handouts plugin, it's typically best to do this at the end so that you don't lose the focus of your attendees. Well, that's it for this video, folks. By this point, you should have a clear understanding of how you can activate your audience with Livestorm's engagement features, how to customize your event room, and how to share resources so that you can get the most out of your events. Now, don't hesitate to hit that subscribe button for the latest tips on hosting engaging online meetings and events. We have a lot more great content coming soon, so stay tuned. Until then, keep creating, keep engaging, and keep those connections alive. I'll see you soon. Take care.